Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we're back with Manasji again, my senior godmother. He had explained very beautifully the last time about the eighth house, and today now the sun is almost about to set here in Germany, and we all know where the sun is when he's setting down. He's in the seventh house. He is in the seventh house of marriage, spouse, relationships, business partners. But these are all words that we know, we are already aware of. But that's not why Manasji comes here. He comes here to speak something which we don't know. We know it, but maybe we still don't see, or we have never heard something, okay? So yes, sir, welcome back. And the stage is yours. As usual, please enlighten us about the seventh house. All yours.
Thank you so much, Abhijit. So, yeah, very, very nice time is that. Like, it is a Godhuli Bela. It's kind of when the sun is going to set. And you must know that this is a kind of Sandhya in our Vedic injunctions. We can understand it. This is a Sandhya. No? So, what is the important this Sandhya, and how we can relate it with our life? So you see, when the sun sets, what happens? It becomes dark. Okay. So if you will see the Brihat Parashar Hora Shastra, it will say one of the things this seventh house represents is blindness. It's blindness. Interestingly. So, how blind does it mean? Actual eye is getting blind, or vision is getting disturbed? So, whether the actual eye is getting blind or not, the vision is getting disturbed. That is for sure. So, seventh house is a time when what happens? The sun is setting. So, sunset means it hovers darkness all around. When the darkness is all around, then that means it is a phase when then at that time you take help of torch to guide yourself. That torch, however big it would be, it cannot be as mighty as sun. No, that torch is your business partners, your spouse, is like who will help you, no? But how much they can help you, you cannot have its comparison when you are comparing it with a actual spiritual knowledge of Vedas. So basically, sun is a glowing sun, which is actual spiritual knowledge. So seventh house, rather. They know getting entangled in a life where you are having less inclination towards spirituality. Okay. So let's understand it this way. First house was what your body. No? So seventh house was like better half of your body is wife. Okay. When wife comes in your life, what happens? A new life, we will say a new life has started. Why? Because you are getting new set of so many responsibilities. When you're getting new set of so many responsibilities, your mind is kind of entangled in more entangled in solving all problems which would come I would say to make the time more easier, to make the married life more easier, kind of that. So this is a different path which you might not have thought when you would have remained a bachelor. So this is a complete trajectory change. Similar thing is that, let's say you are starting a new business. Okay. You before starting a business, you may contemplate that, okay, this may be the way, this may be the turn I will take. But actually, when you start the business, a new thing, a new arena opens. And you actually get engrossed into it. Now, so all these things, basically what binds you, and it gives you a sense of what a torchlight, a light, that means there is something ahead. But the thing is that there is darkness, and it is very difficult to move with very much swiftly as it would have been in sun. Okay, so the main theme of seventh house is more about that change of course of life. It is kind of that. And if I would like to understand it with aspect of other houses, okay, so you see, from fifth house it is third house. No, so intelligence. Now, when you talk, when you take suggestion of your colleagues, from your wife, your better half, intelligence gets help. No, when a time when it may happen that it is not possible from your self intelligence to cope up with something, but at that time seven helps. No, so it is with the aspect of 5-3 relation, friend of five. No, again you can understand from the aspect of sixth house is something your challenges. No, your challenges are something which is basically something you can handle. This is what sixth house says. No, individually sixth house says. When it comes to seventh house, it becomes more easy because the handling becomes more easy. Why? Because in sixth house, you were dealing with your, but now seventh house gives companions. So with the similar like-minded companions, it becomes easy. Now the whole context is set up that things become easy. It becomes easy to a certain level. And this certain level is something that makes you pacified. Now, the interesting thing is that if somebody is pacified, he doesn't want to achieve something out of the box. If you are pacified, if you are in peaceful situation, no, you would not like to break out the box. So that's why it is more... it is more emphasized on the fact that it is it gives you blindness.
Interesting.
So that's all I think for seventh house, which I could.
Yeah, that's very true. I mean, when you, that's something very beautiful, which I liked when you said about the seventh house being the third from the fifth. That's very important. I think that our intelligence gets help, and sometimes if the seventh house is not very good, then that can also mislead us at times, as they say, na, that you are an average of the five best people that you are around. And if you see fifth from the seventh house is also the 11th house, which is the house of Sangha and association, as they say. So therefore it's and that's also the directly the opposite from the fifth house, the 11th house. So I guess it's very important to have good people around us, you know, who can give us good suggestions, good not just suggestions out of their own experience, but those which are, you know, backed by scriptural evidence, you know, from scriptural study, from scriptural realization, from spiritual elevation rather. So this is something which I really liked. And if this doesn't happen, then it takes us to the other side. You know, it can take us to tamas and andhakar, as they say. Om Agyan Timirandhasya, as they say. The guru pulls out the disciple out of the ignorance. So yeah, that's something very interesting.
One of the most interesting thing in the seventh house is that you see our chart. From the right portion of our chart is always an enlightened portion. You see the 11th house, 10th house, 12th house, 9th house. You can see the manifested effect of these houses in your life. But all of the houses which are from 7th house to 1st house, those are lying are the shuttle houses. These are actually the internal building force, and the right portion of the all of the six houses, those are the enlightened, those are manifested. Like if someone is having ninth association of ninth house, he will be immediately able to see the shelter in his life. If somebody is having 10th house, he will be able to see it in form of material satisfaction and all, determination and all. 11th house, gain. Anything you add, gain. 12th house, anything you add, it will pulverize. Okay. 8th house, deep contemplation. All of these things are what you can actually see if you're knowing a person, what phase he is going through. You can estimate by just talking with that person. Because it is manifested in his life. It is very much manifested. But the internal things are all 1, 2, 6. These are internal things. These are which is hidden beside you. You might not be able to know all these things in first meeting, or maybe if the person is kind of intelligent, then you might not be able to understand him even after meeting so many times. So this is these are like what is hidden inside, and right portion of the our chart is like manifest. Just wanted to add. Yeah, so after this we might be to secret portion of the chart.
we have done the manifested portion, now it's in the unmanifested internal side. Well, thank you very much once again. It's a great pleasure and honor to learn from you and from your experience that you have had from your gurus. And yes, once again, if anybody is interested to get a consultation from him, which many of you will be, I am sure, then I will pin his email ID below in the description section. Please go and send him a mail. And please be respectful. He's a very busy person. As I said in the last video, he's also teaching astrology, but now due to the interest of time, he's not able to accept more students. Hopefully in the future, when he does it in a bigger scale, then I will announce in my channel and all of you can go and join his group, including myself. And then, so until then, he's available for consultations. Okay. And please be respectful of his time and do not message him unnecessary queries like, you know, my this planet is here, what will happen? It doesn't work like that. All right. Thank you very much and wish you all the best. See you soon again with the other side of the horoscope.